Hi, I'm Pete, the developer of Knitting Chart, and this video is about working with a PDF pattern in the app, and especially the changes in the latest version number 7.1. So let's take a look at what's new. First, on the left, you still have the option to show the counters panel like this, which also includes the timer at the bottom. So I will close this down for now. Here is the option to show the thumbnails panel. And this is a new tool. It's to place objects on top of your document. So there used to be some options here, like for instance, the rectangle and also the text, but new is, for instance, placing rulers, markers, and info dots. So let's start at the top. The first option is to cut out a portion of your PDF and then save it as a separate image. This is a vertical ruler to place in your document. This is a horizontal ruler. This is just a tiny little marker, and this is an info dot, which can include text, an image, or a link. And this is a text box, and this is just a colored rectangle. So let's take a look at the rulers first. If I select this one, horizontal ruler, and then tap anywhere in the document, then you have a new horizontal ruler. And you can use the handles to rescale it and use extra tools to change the color. Same goes for the vertical ruler. Just select the vertical ruler here and then tap anywhere to place it. So this could make it easy to keep track of your current row and stitch in a chart. You can place some notes on top of your chart using the info dot tool here and then tap anywhere to place it like this. So you can add some notes about the bind-off method you're using or which yarn you're using, stuff like that. You can use the extra tools at the bottom to change it to an image. So you can also use this to add a progress image, for instance, or a link to a tutorial of a technique which is shown in the pattern, for instance. Next is the move tool, which you use when you're navigating your document. You want to zoom into it or you want to select an object, for instance, by tapping on it like this. The last three tools are for drawing ink annotations on top of your chart. So this could be a highlighter, which are these ones, or a pen like this. So if you're using the pen, you can just write on top of your chart. If you select the highlighter, you can highlight, for instance, important sections or text in your pattern. Use the eraser to remove any drawn text from your document. If you want to remove objects like rulers or info dots, first use the select tool here, then tap on it, and then select the trash tool here, like this. The thumbnail panel has some extra options. If you tap on the button on the selected page, like this, you can delete the page, insert a blank page, or also rotate the pages in any direction. You can also tap and hold on the page, and then like this, drag it to a new position. Okay, that's it. Hope you enjoy these new changes in the app, and I'll see you next time, of course.